So for those of you that are familiar with my channel, you know that quite a few of my videos are about treadmills and treadmill parts. And because of that, I have gotten a lot of comments asking questions about things they've seen in my videos and other parts of treadmills, that kind of thing. And so this is just going to be a video to go over some of those frequently asked questions.
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
The next question I get all the time is, where do I get the RC circuit? In my earlier videos, both my building a quality power supply video and my video on basic treadmill motor controls, I recommend using what's called an RC circuit. That is a capacitor and a resistor that get wired in parallel with the motor to help, again, filter out power spikes. Now, when I was originally doing testing, using a circuit like that made a huge difference when used with the motor, but with nothing else. Once I added the choke into the mix, the RC circuit became a whole lot less important. Now, my RC circuits I made from defunct boards. So this is a capacitor, and that's the resistor from an old type MC2100 board that is defective. It does not work. And I was able to cut this out and then solder on to the two terminals, keeping in mind that capacitors are polarized. So you have a negative terminal, that one, and then the unmarked positive terminal. And that's how I was able to get mine. Now, you could make one if you knew the specific specs, but the problem is capacitors are really not a one size fits all. Each capacitor, like this capacitor on this board, is designed to work with a specific set of components. So to harvest it from here, I have a better chance of it working properly, but it's still probably not the best option. And in retrospect, I've learned that really it's not necessary and not something that really you need to worry about. I had one on several machines, and there might have been marginal improvement in power spikes and such, but again, hard to tell because I was running chokes. But the biggest thing that I noticed, especially on my lathe, is if I was putting the motor under an extreme load, having the capacitor in place would cause a slight pulsing or a power surge. And if you're doing something that, you know, is tight tolerances, that kind of thing, you don't want the speed to be pulsing. So ultimately, I've removed the RC circuits from my shop tools, and it's really not that critical that you run one.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.